In this contest, we have chosen certain texts for the hadith. Inshallah, there will be we're going to understand the methodology of Imam Bukhari and Imam Muslim. That how these two people, they have spent their life to collect the data and all the hadith which are available in their time, and then how they categorized them, how they put them in different categories, and then how they decided which are authentic, which are not authentic, what hadith are sound, what are not sound, what is the methodology that they have been following, and how they have been consistent in following the methodology. And really, in this matter, I have seen that Imam Bukhari and Muslim both are as academic as possible. Actually, academic of our time, they don't have this rigorous study in their field of knowledge. But Imam Bukhari and Muslim, they for every single hadith, they have done the full research, and every single hadith to them is actually independent case. They look in that properly. They just don't follow some general category. For example, some people will say to you, the sound hadith is the one which has got five conditions. So you think it is so easy. Look five conditions and hadith is sound. This is not how Bukhari Muslim have been. That why people in our generation, they have done so many mistakes. Because they think it is a category which has this certain definition. Whatever fits in their definition, it can be sound and sahih. They don't do this thing. They basically, they study every single hadith independently. It could be actually, there are some hadith narrated by those people who fulfill all the conditions. But still Bukhari Muslim don't consider them as sahih, as sound hadith. It could be there are hadith narrated by those people who don't have all these conditions properly. But still you can find their hadith in sahih Bukhari Muslim. Because these poor people, they are not only looking in these certain categories or definition. They look for the certain things more than that. They do more research. So that we have to try to understand really that what is their methodology, how they determine that some hadith sound or sahih and some are not sound or sahih. What is their methodology? So inshallah that I'm going to study and teach properly with proper examples from Bukhari and Muslim, both from both books, and especially the Muqaddimah of Imam Muslim, which he has written to discuss his own methodology. So that one thing I'm going to discuss. The second thing, inshallah, is in this respect also is that Imam Bukhari rahimahullah ta'ala's opinion is that it is not that only Muslims should follow sound hadith. Actually, he wants to also prove that sound hadith, they are enough for the religion. So that why in his Sahih Bukhari, he uses the same hadith to derive many, many other rulings. So what is his methodology for his fiqh? How he derives the ruling from the sound hadith? So he wants to prove that people only need sound hadith, and second, he wants to prove it, the sound hadith is enough for your religion, and you can actually base everything on those sound hadith. So that is the fiqh of the Bukhari, which is people say actually fiqh al-Bukhari fi tarajimihi. So when he makes chapter headings and then he makes argument, he makes this thing very clear. So these two books in the hadith.